Now, Brendan, I've mentioned already in the show the cancel culture. I have a shocking example at the end of the show too. It seems that Harry and Meghan, the runaway royals, are now the prince and princess of cancelling. They've joined in the pressure on the audio streaming site Spotify. Spotify hosts the hugely popular podcast of American Joe Rogan, who likes having on guests with whom he disagrees. And in one case, Rogan interviewed controversial vaccine expert Dr. Robert Malone, who's against the virus vaccine. A lot of people say it's discredited, but Rogan gave him a hearing. Now, in protest, singer Neil Young told Spotify to ban Rogan or he'd walk. Well, Spotify told Neil Young to take a hike. But now Harry and Meghan, who have a deal with Spotify, say they've been telling it for months that they're worried about COVID misinformation on its platform. They made a public announcement to this effect. What do you make of all that?
I'm shocked by this whole situation. You know, we have these hippies for censorship like Neil Young and more recently Joni Mitchell, who are basically calling on a massive corporation to ditch someone who they disagree with, to ditch Joe Rogan because they don't like him. That's, you know, these old hippies from the 60s and 70s now agitating for corporate censorship. And of course, Harry and Meghan have to stick their beak in. There's never been a woke bandwagon they haven't tried to jump on, and now they're getting involved too. The prince and princess of cancellation, as you say, that's exactly what they're aspiring to be. They've always wanted to control how people think, and they now see an opportunity to do that through Spotify, even though they've never even made any podcast for Spotify. They got paid a lot of money for doing not very much at all.
In fact, they got paid $34 million Australian to do podcasts for Spotify, and they still haven't produced one. I mean, I think Spotify should have told them to take a hike as well. Instead, it's buckled. Here's the bad news for you. It said it's going to add a content advisory to any podcast episode now that includes a discussion about COVID-19, which is a kind of health warning, and it's going to test ways to highlight its platform rules to raise awareness about what's acceptable. I tell you what, Brendan, internet censorship is galloping on us at a huge pace now.
Absolutely, and it's something we should be very worried about indeed. You know, big tech companies are unaccountable and incredibly powerful. We shouldn't be calling on them to determine what we're allowed to listen to or what we're allowed to see. And I think the people who are doing that are on a hiding to nothing when they call for that kind of censorship.
Absolutely. Look, I tell you what, we're looking more and more like a Chinese-style media censorship if we're not careful. Brendan and Neil, thank you for your time.